I have no speech to deliver, no message to convey, no intention to grab the trophy. I'm serious. In fact, I'm here to tell someone in front of you all that I love you. I still love you. Toastmaster and guests, release your breath. I'm not addressing any one of you. Loretta Young cited, love isn't something you find. Love is something that finds you. Love is such a small word, but it changed someone's entire life. Love is the sole word that can never describe the way we feel it. Love is the sole thing which each and every person in this universe has experienced. Oh yeah, including Toastmaster Balaji as well. I had never believed in love. I consistently disliked novels and romantic movies. I felt pity on couples who went into love marriages. I provoked my lover friends by throwing parties on their breakup days. My belief that love is artificial became stronger once the partners betrayed each other. With zero knowledge, I wasn't sure what destiny was preparing for me. My palm plants were fluctuating without my permission. Unexpectedly, I met someone, somehow, somewhere, and my fate bound me to fall for him. My palm plants withdrew the option to escape. My impression about love was different until I met him. Once I met him, in silence, my ears heard the rhythm of violin. My nose smelled the fragrance of the air. My body raised in the space. My arms and legs were bouncing without my permission. My smile deprived the restriction and allowed my 32 teeth 30 teeth to express the immeasurable feelings joyously. My eyes were astonishingly sparkled to witness the scene. My heart was breakdancing and mine was laughing. I still feel it the same way though it was 6 years back when our fate bound us to fall for each other. Give me an opportunity to have faith in love. Being in love changed my entire universe. Being in love allowed me to visualize many intangible things. I witnessed the real beauty in people and sensed the purity. He promised to live together, and I believe in what he said. He taught me 3 key elements to remember, believe, and use in my life. Number 1, believe in the appearance of intangible things. Number 2, always excuse people rather than being judgmental. Number 3, love yourself, but don't you wait. Understanding the first 2 points were stress-free for me. But getting the 3rd point, I was having no idea that it would take approximately 6 years, 5 months, and 38 days. 39. Yeah. Finally, the day we waited for so long arrived. Our engagement day. I was circled by beloved who were actively preparing me to become the prettiest bride. My face was glowing like the moon conquer my imagination about love on the piece of paper would require a spiritual who deals with the spiritual world. While stepping towards the door of happiness, with a huge smile on my face, my mother stopped me all of a sudden by pulling my hand. Her eyes were full of sorrow. Her eyes were full of tears, along with sorrow on her face. She said, "I'm so sorry, but you can't go out." "Why not? Everyone is waiting for me, Mother." "No one is waiting for anyone anymore. Mother, we are getting late, and he hates delay. He won't get annoyed, he's no more alive." She replied. "He met through an accident and lost his life while I was getting prepared to be his bride. I felt the destiny was making fun of me, love was teasing, and God was punishing me. Most of the people say that love is a gift from God. If it's a prison, then why is it snatched from us? Why we fight for it? Why we get bored of it? Why we are insecure about it?" Toastmaster and guests, as rightly said by Megan, the author, "I never knew what love was until I met you. When the distance pulled us apart, I found out what true love is. Did my life stop? Yes, for a decade. Did my feeling vanish? Never. Do I believe in love? Yes, I do. Do I love him? Yes, I do. But I'll keep going as he wanted." I still remember his last words. "I love you, but don't wait. I won't wait, I promise."